And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. We are in the library, the something, the Hall of Revealed Mysteries, right? We are reading books, we are reading descriptions, we are reading dialogue, we're reading everything. So.
No problem.
Hopefully, you guys are cool with that. Let's see. Gonna look up in here, see what we got in this little area. Looks like some kind of study or reading center or something like that. Reading is fundamental. No entry into the archives without Grimda's permission. Well, we might be able to pick that, but you're standing there. You probably won't be happy if we just go in there, so let's go in here.
My eyes are peeled.
What?
Sneak! Oh, sneaky priest. What we got? Daily Affirmations of Focus and Efficiency and the Saints' War Part 1. Let's see if we have those. Certainly don't want to read stuff over again that we already have. They were grayish, so let's look there first. Saints War Part 1. Alright, right there. And Daily Affirmations, so... that's what we got, right? Yeah, I'm going to not steal those. How about these? Final Journal of Jonas and the Missives of the Hand Occult. Those are new. I'll read those. Hopefully not too long. My son, tomorrow I become the effigy. Tomorrow I become Scan's embodiment of Iora. Tomorrow my master chokes on his own whip. For months we met by secret conclave to plot our landlord's demise, all the while working the fields as if our hearts were content. Scan teaches us to plot with the mind while keeping one's face impassive, inscrutable. Fair fights or for those with armies. The quiet slave is our whetstone, our focus. In his worship, our cause finds focus, clarity, and possibility. Tomorrow, my master chokes on his own whip. Let's see if you said that. By the time you read this, I will be dead. I pray Skane does not abandon me for speaking of my plotting, but a son deserves to know how his father died, for I have volunteered to be the effigy. Skane will inhabit my body, using this old farmer's simple flesh as a puppet of godly rage. I have been shaved and anointed. Tomorrow morning I will be your father in name only, as my manhood will be removed. Wow. My nose and ears removed, and my useless mortal eyes will be replaced with flint stones through which Scan might see the world. This sounds like a rollicking good time, I gotta tell you. My son, I am sorry for the lies I have told you these past few seasons, but Scan demands secrecy. Even your mother knows nothing of the furtive service to the quiet slave. Curse my name if you must, but never weep for me, for I die for the betterment of our community, to smite our lord's corruption from the face of Iora. Tomorrow my master chokes on his own whip, for tomorrow I become the effigy. No, I think you've just lost your mind. Missives of the Hand Occult. Dearest brother, or was it sister? May this letter find you in well spirits. A man of thuggish bearing stormed into my library the other day and demanded I help him find a book on the construction of an arquebus. I thought it proper service to Whale to steer this man toward an illuminated manuscript on the subject of whittling toy soldiers and other miniature props. Unamused by my solution, I shrugged and said, "What is an answer without a question?" He did not find my spiritual rhetoric helpful or amusing, and so he punched out two of my teeth. I trust your summer has been less tumultuous than mine? In more important news, my apprentice claims she saw the eyeless face in a dream the other night. I admit I was so mad with envy that at first I refused to believe her. Whale, forgive me for such a lapse of judgment. She described an Omawa of brilliant blue hues with a featureless face surrounded by a swarm of eyes. No two eyes alike. She claims Whale ignored her questions, and she can't recall any specifics of what was said. In fact, my apprentice seems to have forgotten many things since before the visitation. She could not tell me where she grew up or what she'd like to eat. That's not good. At first I was envious of her for having seen Whale with her own eyes, but it seems Whale's visit was to conceal, not to illuminate. I pray she endures this test of faith and can look back at the event and feel the joy of mystery. What is an answer without a question? Last week I felt the solution was ignorance, but after Whale's visit, I feel a road without length is closer to the capturing of the riddle. I worry my apprentice will look back at her visit from Whale and feel cheated, robbed of some moment of clarity we all thought we were owed when we first joined. I tried to tell her she was lucky, but she was too young to understand. What is an answer without a question? May I be dead and my soul scattered to the winds before anyone knows for certain. That's pretty heavy stuff there as well. All right.
Fight.
Eh?
Ooh, Elder Archives, that's what that says. I think we're talking to her. Grimda. May the 100 visions be revealed to you. Why, thank you. Impossibly, this painted eye seems to move whenever you turn your back. Hello, Grimda.
Hail, traveler.
An elderly dwarf surveys the stacks. Her skin looks as tough and wrinkled as a walnut. Despite her stature, she manages to look down her nose at you. You're welcome to look around, but let the priests and scriveners continue their search. She shoots the nearest robe figure a withering glare. Wouldn't do to give them any other excuses. I'd like to know more about Whale. I find it weird to just walk up to someone and say, tell me about yourself, so I asked that. Her smile reveals a row of crooked teeth. That's the rub, isn't it? Whale is the god of things hidden and revealed. The more of the 100 visions one sees, the more one has yet to discover. Though we often call Whale he who sees and is not seen, it is neither male nor female. To assign any definitive characteristic to Whale is to miss another essential part of its divinity. The 100 visions? A term of reverence for Whale's many revelations. Despite the name, they're infinite. Every epiphany leads to yet another enigma. Sounds complicated. Sagani says, and I thought I was busy. What else do you need? Okay, now tell me more about yourself. Or tell me about yourself. I am the High Archivist of the Hall of Revealed Mysteries. She coughs loudly into her fist, and I am too old and too busy to be bothered with inane questions. Imagine if I asked you this question straight off. Kanna sighs, even just one or two? What are the scriveners looking for? Maybe I could find it. She sizes you up, stroking her chin. Could you now? She scowls at the robe priests again. You certainly could do worse than this lot, anyway. Or couldn't do worse than this lot. Thieves made off with an ancient scroll of Whale. They intend to blaspheme by selling that which should remain hidden, a secret of the hundred visions. Her wiry eyebrows arch over her spectacles. The guards caught one of them, but were overzealous in their interrogation. All they could piece together was something about a farmhouse and the road to Deerford. Track the thieves down. I don't care what you do with them, but bring back the scroll. Whale rewards the persistent seeker, and so do I. Kanna says, an ancient scroll of Whale? That's a fine prize. I mean, a worthy task. I have questions about the missing scroll. Ask. What's so special about this scroll? Whale is the god of secrets. If I told you that, I'd cheapen it, wouldn't I? she cackles. It's a parable, the kind that nourishes the inquisitive mind and poisons the foolish. Tell me what you know about the thieves. Very little, except that they were foolish to believe they could steal from the God of Secrets. That, and they were fleeing to a farmhouse. How should I handle the thieves? However you can. Kill them, rob them, leave them. It makes no difference to me. She waves a hand and smiles grimly. I'll consider it one of Wales' mysteries. I'll return with the scroll. Alright. Guess we're done in here. I don't want to anger them by taking books. I might come back here and mess with it, but... I don't want to take books when they can see us. I've snuck and taken a few. We read them last episode. But, yeah, I don't want to press my luck. Besides, that would probably mean I'd spend the whole rest of this episode in that library reading them. So let's go this way instead. Yes, the personalized messages. Many of them break the fourth wall, so players desiring complete immersion may wish to avoid clicking them. I've never seen that saying. Oh, it's nighttime. Okay, we were going in counterclockwise. There were people here. We talked to them. Scrivener's dormitory. Oh, okay. Maybe we could find out more about these thieves. Well, scriveners don't seem to have much of a clue. Although you never know. Maybe they know more than they're letting on. See, we've talked to them. Well, we've looked at them. We've seen secrets about them. History. Okay. Spilled tea, empty ink pots, and one detailed sketch of a fire-breathing old dwarf are all that remain of a long study session. There's like nobody around in here. 126 copper skeets. Who caught us? Who's here? Slight. I should have been sneaking. Damn it. I'm gonna keep it real, though. Who saw us? There's nobody here. Is there someone there? There's nobody here.
Laying low.
Yeah, there's gotta be some... Him! I didn't see him. Make sure we're not caught again. From now on, we'll always sneak. Ooh, a scroll of cackling bolt. Requires more lore than we have, but...
Bye!
We'll hold on to it. Hello there.
Greetings.
By Whale's eyeless face, you are one short ogre. But why are you green, and how are you getting the ducks to keep flying around you like that? Let's just ask, what are you talking about? Your ducks, your green skin. Should I speak louder? Slower? Let me know. He beams at you and nods his head. You're a scrivener? He nods. Yes, I am a scrivener. I read books. I write books. I once ate a book, but only because it looked like sweet pie. Or perhaps it was sweet pie baked to look like a book. Interesting. Oh. I am also a collector of herbs. Flowers, plants. I sell them. Mostly I eat them. He's on something. He is on something. Oh, he's selling stuff, too. Oh, wow. Tell me about the dormitory. It's where the scriveners who work at the Hall of Revealed Mysteries sleep. I'm a scrivener. He sniffs. This place smells like old stockings. Show me what you have for sale. Caro Galan. Well, it's got all that, and it's made from a secret and uncommon plant that grows deep in Ir Glanfath. Caro Galan is a name given to a mixture typically used solely for ceremonial purposes or else by warriors going into important battles. It is said to open one's awareness to one's place in the world, raising one's ability to recognize and react to threats. I've seen this black song before. I've seen the... Well, this new ripple sponge? Made from sponges found along the rocky coasts of Ratai, ripple sponge is ground finely and inhaled. It is often used on long sea voyages, for it has a soothing, calming effect which helps in tackling extended periods of strenuous activity. White leaf? White leaf is derived from the white leaf weed, which is commonly found throughout the Deerwood and Ir Glanfath. Locals dry and smoke the plant, which grants a feeling of calm alongside an intense lethargy. So this guy is basically a drug dealer. It's alright. Nothing we haven't seen before. The sturdy bunks are topped with thin blankets and even thinner mattresses. Oh, there's something in here. Sneaky time.
Hello? Hello?
Shut up, Canna.
Hmm? I can do that.
Three snow caps, sure.
Yeah.
So, well, he caught us stealing, but I don't see he has the mental faculty to even realize what it is we did. You must be here for Coren. I didn't know how Corin's hidden his little racket from excuse me. Someone's been sneaking naughty picture books from Old Valia into the dorm. I won't say who. Thin blankets, thinner mattresses. It smells like old stockings in here. Yes, we've heard that. We've heard it say such, said say so, and... What are you doing, stealing? The pay is good. I live close to the library, and I can read as many books as I want. A rancid stench rises from the basin. The dishes at the top of the pile are flecked with morsels of meat and cheese. Those at the bottom are covered in a slimy fuzz. Blech. I don't need the vegetables. It's not worth it. It's not worth it, man. Oh, what's this? I just want to see what this is. We probably can't take it. Oh, it's just rice. Who cares? Who cares, man? So, we're done. Making progress here. I guess that guy's the man to see if you want drugs and stuff like that. Ginger ale, yummy. Lumdala's house, that's from our quest. Who's Lumdala? I was supposed to go to Lumdala's house. I think, wasn't I? I don't know. I don't even know. Of course we're gonna go in there. We're gonna go in everywhere. Quest or no, we go.
Laying low.
Excellent. Two lockpicks. Very much needed. This painting depicts the famous scene from The Light of Dawn in which the traveler and the ghost happen upon a starving man. I see. Fruit. Ooh. Western barbican's done. Now, I think... yeah, we can go from here. Okay. Perception bonus. Are we going to get invaded? So we need perception bonuses? Don't answer that if anyone knows. Bright Hollow Restoration. Allow us to rest there. Done. Well, not done, but purchased.
Let's see what lies this way.
A book and 28 silver pfennigs. True Stories from the Living Lands. Let's read it real quick. Only the hardiest of adventurers would dare take the long, dangerous trek to the Living Lands. While there is no denying its beauty, the diversity of plant life alone is an herbologist's dream, the inherent risk in blithely trekking through these pristine hills is more than most should undertake. Let me take a moment to tell you about the land itself. Rolling hills, greenery, and sun. The whole area feels like a succession of hills and valleys, each with its own ecosystem. While that declaration is a tad extreme, it can almost be said to be true. The combination of sun, geographical location, proximity to fresh water, valley depth, and the existence of hot springs have given the Living Lands a wide breadth of flora and fauna. Walk down a hillside into a valley and you will find lush, verdant hills. Climb the next rise and you might see nothing but rock and boiling mineral springs. And the creatures. In my travels, I've seen it all, and this place never ceases to amaze me. Trolls. I will never forget my encounter with the trolls of the Living Lands. I had just narrowly avoided being consumed by a giant plant, more on that later, and was running as fast as I could to get away from it. I broke the crest of the hill, and the valley below it was wide, green, wet, and covered with low, thick branched trees. Vines grew everywhere, between the trees, across the top of them, down to the ground, it as a mess of vine and green. Cautiously, I worked my way down toward the basin, keeping an eye out for anything suspicious, and it's a good thing I did so. I noticed not all the trees appeared to be trees. I froze, dropping to the ground in an effort to minimize my appearance. One of the trees moved, lumbering away from the cluster. It's then that I realized it was a troll, stepping out from among the group of trees it had been resting against. With a few more homes, I would have... Sorry, guys. I think I need rest. With a few more steps, I would have walked right into their home. The camouflage these trolls exhibited far exceed any I had ever seen before. I hope to return again in the future and observe them more. You just don't get them coming after you. Insects. While I have never seen them, I have read reports of giant insects in the Living Lands. Are we gonna come across these? Centipedes, flies, mosquitoes, and hornets, all 10 times the size you would see them elsewhere. Imagine making camp. You've just gotten everything set up. There's a nice fire going next to your shelter. Something is gently simmering in the cooking pot. You sit down, finally feeling like you can relax after a trying day. You feel a tickling at your feet, insistent and prolonged. Reaching down to brush whatever is away, your hand comes in contact with something hard, long, and flexible, winding its way around your boot. You look down to see the centipede the size of your arm casually making its way over your feet toward the far side of the camp. You would get out of that camp, wouldn't you? That's exactly what my friend did when he realized he had started his fire over a centipede nest. Plants. And lest we forget, do not let your guard down around the plants. I had discovered a wonderful collection of giant flowers. They were bright pink and grew in a circle around a central stalk. What an aroma! I lacked the words to describe how delectable it was. Sweet, fruity, and light, with just a hint of something tangy. Looking closer, I saw some berries growing on the stalk in the center of the flowers. Well, I just had to have them. So I started pushing my way through the flowers. Then the vines growing around the base of the plant began to twitch, and the blooms turned towards me. It was at that moment I saw the blooms weren't actually flowers, but hinged jaws. I had been fooled by its camouflage. I quickly retreated, pushing my way back out, just in time. The blooms slammed shut. If I had still been standing there, trying in vain to reach the berries, I wouldn't be writing this book today.
Let's see what lies this way.
You already found it. That's pretty interesting. The Living Lands. Do we go to the Living Lands at some point? There's nothing here. Oh, we don't have a key. We need him's key. Not in here? No. And that had only vegetables. We're gonna have to come back here when we have a key. I don't know why that name sounds so familiar though. I don't know. I do not know. That's okay. I'd rather just... yeah, be where our group is. That kind of thing. Hail, Justice CR. The Crucible Knights weren't always soldiers. We used to be blacksmiths. That's fascinating, Justice CR. World map? So really this goes out? That's literally world map, okay. Making our way around once more. Only the best soldiers get to patrol the palace.
I shall be discreet.
Oh, a rope and grappling hook. We have that. Okay. So what's this place? Purnisc's. Oh, Purnisc. Yes, we have to make him see to his the error of his ways. He's beating his wife and fun stuff with his friends. He's on drugs and all that kind of thing. Yeah, they're kind of laying around a lot. Mercenary addict.
Got it.
Hail. Hail, addicts. Wait, what's happening? Am I imagining this? Purnisc always has the best supply. Mercenary says, I told you to keep clear. What? Well, they are fighting us, right?
Brave.
I don't remember him saying to keep clear. Because I looked there. Well, he'll see the error of his ways shortly. Thank you. Yeah. You know, he's only one right now. I'm sure there's others coming, so let's do Soul Shock for now, and we'll save the better one for after. For later. Oh, chunks. Oh, here comes another one. Until it gets closer, so we can see him better. Can he see? Not really.
Eh?
Now we can. Oh boy, here we go. Knockdown. I'm really not using any special ranger stuff, I'm just gonna have him attack. I actually forgot about our priest for a while. Don't I get to choose where it goes? No? I choose an area of effect? No? Oh, he's all the way... Oh, God. Wait, he's back here. You're not helping anyone over here. Get up here. Yeah. Where is she? She's stuck in the middle of all this. Oh, she's right here, okay. Shield. Can't use that. That's no good. These are area of effect spells. I can't do that right now. Same with that. Hold on. Is this full AoE? Well, that's just AoE, which means it won't hurt everybody. What about Noxious? Yep, AoE. So okay, let's do combusting wounds. On these three guys. Nerid says, stop! Nerid staggers back, holding a bloody hand in front of him. I give up. Just leave and I'll go peacefully, alright? There's only one option. Too late. Is that Prinisk's hand? I need some healing. Restore moderate endurance. Where is she? Kana. Sagani, yeah, we need to put it over here. What else has he got? Warding seal? Look at these after. Did he cast a spell? On Fiwa. Oop. Heal up there. Where's Eater? Is he even attacking anyone right now? Okay, everyone on this guy. And now that guy.